Let us now discuss the standard paraxial incident rays and refracted rays for thin lenses. These rays we are going to study for understanding of image formation by thin lenses, as for image formation we need at least two incident rays and corresponding refracted rays. And details of image formation we will study in next section, and right now here we will study about some standard rays which are used for image formation. And we'll study for both convex lenses as well as concave lenses. And here we'll consider convex lens as converging lenses. And we assume that these are placed in rarer surrounding. And for concave lenses, here we consider these as diverging lenses, as if these are placed in a rarer surrounding. Here in this situation, if we just have a look on this convex lens and its principal axis, there are two focal points on the two sides of a thin lens. Here I am denoting the focal points as only F and F, because we have studied that for a thin lens on both the sides, the focal length remains same. It is independent of the direction from which light rays is incident. And here we can consider if a light ray is incident parallel to the principal axis, then after refraction, this ray will pass through the focal point on the other side of the lens, as we can see in this picture. And similar counterpart for concave lens, here we can see if a light ray is allowed to incident on a concave lens which is parallel to the principal axis, then after refraction it will diverge in such a manner that it appears to be coming from the focal point which is behind the lens on the opposite side of the refracted ray. The second ray here we can see, this is the ray for a convex lens which incident on the optic center of the lens. Here we can see this will pass undeviated, as at the middle point of the lens it behaves like a glass slab, and as it is considered to be a thin lens, lateral displacement will be negligibly small. However, if we magnify the lens, here we can see there will be a slight lateral displacement due to the parallel surface of the lens through which the light is passing. But in macroscopic view, we can see it appears to be the same light which is passing undeviated. And the same counterpart here we can see in concave lens. If a light ray incident onto the optic center of the lens, it is assumed that it is passing undeviated. It is considered it is passing undeviated through the lens. And the third ray here we can see on the convex lens, so which passes through the focal point before incident on the lens, and it is considered that after refraction through the two surfaces of lens, it becomes parallel to the principal axis. And the same ray we can consider for concave lens. If we consider a ray which is incident on the lens in such a manner that it was going toward the other focus of the lens on the other side of the lens, then due to its diverging behavior, after refraction through the two surfaces of lens, it becomes parallel to the principal axis. And you must keep one thing in mind, that all these three different rays are considered only if the incident rays are paraxial, which are very close to principal axis at a small angle to it. Then only these standard refracted rays are considered for image formation.